So I just got my hands on the new Antelope Discrete 8 audio interface along with the Verge microphone. Join me into the rabbit hole as we found what this can do for your studio. Let's start with the Antelope Discrete 8. If you haven't already watched the unboxing video, go check it now as I go through the basics of this unit. Let's dive a little deeper now. You already know that you get 8 discrete mic preamps, mic preamp modeling, real-time FPGA effects, rock-solid clocking, and you can create up to 4 custom monitoring mixes with FPGA effects. And you can also remote control the discrete with your Android or iPhone. But I'm sure everyone will ask, how does it sound? Well, I did some comparisons with some other great interfaces, and I have to say this sound card has the best D2A converters in its price range. But we didn't stop there. If we look on the software, the team over Antelope did an incredible job to build a launcher that will help you install everything you need and stay up to date with no hassle at all. It's that simple to work the launcher. And I was amazed to find out that updates come very, very often. So you know you're not left behind. Now, a big kudos also to the support team at Antelope. I had personally a case where I just went to their website, click on the live chat, said, "Hi, I have an issue, can you help?" And in a matter of 10 minutes, my issue was fixed in a breeze. Compare that to the support you get from other companies, where you have to create a support ticket and wait for them to get back to you after days with a single email. So the Discrete 8 goes up to 192 kHz and sounds amazing. But what is more amazing is the latency in this unit. I have no idea how they did it, but I was able to have 1 millisecond round-trip latency with 96 kHz. This is insane for a USB 2 connection. I haven't tried the Thunderbolt connection, but they say it gets even lower. Okay, so next we have the Verge microphone that you can emulate a wide plethora of other vintage microphones. Thankfully, here at the Sierra Studios, we have a lot of microphones, so we will put it to the test and find out how close those emulations are. Let's start with acoustic guitar and the Sennheiser MKH40. Next, let's try some microphones we use widely for recording drums. The AKG D112 for the kick drum. I know most people prefer the SM57 for the snare drum, but I prefer the Sennheiser 441. Let's see how close the Verge microphone can get. A classic for miking the hi-hat is the Neumann KM184. Let's listen to that one. Okay, now let's try the Verge against the Schweppes CMC6 while recording a string quartet from a distance. Next, let's try the BNK4006 microphone as a room microphone for electric guitar. And finally, as a bonus, we have one last comparison with the Edge Duo microphone. Can it really emulate a Ribbon Royer 121R? Let's listen. Thanks for watching, guys. If you didn't like the video, then you know what to do. But if you liked it, press the like button, leave a comment below, and tell me which emulations you think were the closest. Don't forget to subscribe for more upcoming videos, and I hope to see you again soon.